Evening folks, this is BestInSlot, and as promised yesterday we are going to do a tour of our full zoo so far. The African Adventure section is officially, for now at least, we'll talk about that at the end, it is officially for now finished. I've done the final exhibit. The Gemsbok we did yesterday has changed a little bit. I really didn't expect it to change this much. You'll see when we get there. But it is for now finished. So we're going to explore the entire park, obviously focusing on the African Adventure, but I figured we'll chuck in the start of the zoo as well. So here we are. Unfortunately, my entrance isn't that exciting. I'm wondering if I can knock this down and redo it. A lot of people have built really interesting park entrances, and I'm kind of using the default one with O stuck on the front, so hopefully we can maybe change that up. We kick things off with the hippo, bearing in mind this is the first thing I made. That's broken. I'll have to fix that. So we've got a little downstairs viewing area of our lovely hippos. There's my bed. Oh no, I'm inside the glass. I'm a park guest this time, okay? I must be treated like one. Let's walk up this little hill here. And this is my first elevated viewing area, our very first exhibit. So design-wise, I think hopefully we're going to see some progression through here, poop, through the park. But look at the little baby! And there's another little baby! My hippos are actually breeding like mad at the moment. It's really, really good. But yeah, two little baby hippos and a mama and a papa hippo. Having a grand old time. Might redo this exhibit a little bit. I don't love the papyrus. I actually don't love a lot of the design of this. I might give that another go through to see if we can make it look a little bit nicer. Now that I'm a better player. Moving on. This staff area is very default, so we'll ignore that. Do you have a bucket on your head? Oh no, it's a hat. Okay. Oh, it's the inspector, isn't it? I'm a spy, keeping an eye on her as she inspects my entire park. So this is the bridge over to the main part of the park. This is meant to be like an introductory little section, you know, before you get into the park proper. Well, that's a good sign. Anyway, so this is the bridge over. A lot of people keep telling me to put animals in here. I'm resisting for two reasons. One, the water doesn't go underneath the bridge because the bridge isn't tall enough and the water's not deep enough. But two, I think it's important to have these atmospheric but not exhibit areas in a zoo. I think having these little dead areas with no animals in is what makes your zoo feel more like a zoo. So I'm going to keep those in and keep them animal-less. Anyways, we walk forward. We can hop over the chief beef or indeed get a gulpy. We can also urinate or excavate, evict feces if we so choose. And then we get to the main zoo sign, Buravichar. Now Buravichar was, according to Google Translate, Hindi for bad idea, because we're in Asia. I figured we'll be in India, because why not? It's meant to be bad idea. I've been told it means more like bad thought, but the idea was I'm a terrible zoo designer, so we're going to call it something negative. There's too many people in my zoo. I can't see. Anyways, as we walk forward, a little mechanic bit over there, and over here we have the entrance to African Adventure, as you can see, which I was so proud of when I first made it, and now again I look at it, I'm like, I have replaced the antelope with a gorilla. There's no gorillas, but in a real zoo, in my full zoo, there would be gorillas, so there's a gorilla. It's not even an antelope. Anyway, African Adventure. Let's go and explore this properly, fully, for the very first time. Oh no, you lost your balloon! Littering my goddamn park. Anyways, we walk into African Adventure. We turn to our left, we say, maybe we could get some information here. And you can indeed. Okay, well you can't right now because they've taken a break, but you could get some information here. You could get a gulpy, you could get some loony bloons, if you so chose. I do need to make these a little less boxy, but whatever. Once you've grabbed your gulpy and your balloon, you could hop over here, sit down under this lovely canopied area, excavate your rubbish into the bin. I don't know why I'm obsessed with the word excavate, but I am. And if you wanted, you could go and check out our very first exhibit, the sable antelope. There is looking lovely on this sign. Hippotragus Niger, and he's boxed up perfectly in time. Let's just hop inside. I don't know what you're doing, buddy. We do have a couple of babies. There he is. Look at him. God's sake. What's wrong? Okay, ignore that. Pretend you're not seeing that. Just look at the baby. The baby's adorable. Nice. Go back to being a park guest now. So, nice and simple little picnic area with a sable antelope. Now, that's the staff area. Now, we get over here. We find Franklin. I can't remember what I called him originally, but now it's called Franklin. The hippopotamus. We could go to the left and go to the safari zone, the mandrill, the Cape Buffalo and ostrich, the sable antelope, of course, and the Alberta tortoise. Or you could go to the right for the warthog and some other stuff that I haven't added to the sign quite yet. We're going to go left for now. I'm going to try this in order of what I added it, but we will have a little pit stop to say hi to our Aldebaran tortoise and our tortoise house. Fortunately, he's inside at the moment. He can go inside and outside. My screens are broken. I really need to... Mechanics don't fix these. I need to keep an eye on that a bit more. And the food's filthy. This is a good impression for my zoo right here. Where's my tortoise? There's my Aldebaran tortoise. 100 years old, this little lad is. 100 years old, just having a grand old time. Lives on his own. He's chill. And the whole idea of this is the tortoise house is like an educational kind of thing. You know, I kind of had this vision of all these places I've been to in zoos where it's got like these vinyl walls and then all these like childish patterns on the walls like this and this. And then little conservation boards. And obviously here we've got a big old information screen about all the animals in the zoo. Well, most of the animals in the zoo, I should say. But pretty cool. And there's our little Aldebaran there. So yeah, tortoise house. It's nice, right? I like it in here. Onwards, I don't love the outside. I know other people do, but I don't love it. But the inside is cool. When I fix the screens. I mean, I can't do much about it, guys. Moving on. Let's move on. So the next exhibit we built was the ostrich slash buffalo exhibit. There's our buffalo sign right there. And we do have a buffalo. So you can see them from here. We can see through the chain link a little bit if we want. Stand up against the fence. Or we have our very second, elevated path. We can walk around here. I say walk, I mean zoom forward as though on a Segway or something. And we can look down, we can see our baby ostrich, we can see our mama and papa ostrich, maybe making babies. And I have a buffalo, and there's our buffalo. Cool, let's hop down. Can we hop down? Okay, I think we have to hop down from the bottom. I figure we may as well properly walk around each exhibit as well. It's a little bit cheeky, because we're guests, but still. There is our lovely male ostrich, a breeding machine. Oh, buddy! Where's the babies at? The babies are adorable. Look at it, it's so tiny. Oh. And we've got a single female buffalo. I'm trying to find her a mate, but male buffalo are ridiculously expensive for some reason. She's quite tiny, isn't she? What are you up to? Other than being super, super weird. Oh yeah, the ostrich and buffalo get along really well. I think they make quite a nice combo together. Especially the baby! Anyways, moving on! So, pretend you didn't go down there. You'd carry on up here if you wanted. If you were a staff member in particular, you'd walk down here. Maybe chuck some money in. Get another little look in the exhibit there. And then we've got a little staff area over here. I've got to say, this was workshopped and that was workshopped. These are the only two things I downloaded from the workshop, was the big staff area and that. Even then, I stopped using them after this. For now, yeah. So a little staff corridor bit here, and then we move on, and the next exhibit we're going to look at is, well, I guess the safari zone, because I wanted to go over there to the mandrills. Well, there's the mandrills, but we can't really get there, we have to go back over there, so we'll go to the safari zone since we're here. Here, poop. Oh, God, I love that. Right, so the safari zone, this is our big, big zone, our big statement piece for the African adventure. And... okay, very simple designer. Inside, this is meant to be, you know, like in zoos, where you get the indoor-outdoor bit for your elephants and your giraffes and stuff like that. You can come in here, stand on the asphalt, and look over. And they will come in here. Oh, look, right there. Yay! That's fine. Someone else in there as well? We'll have a little walk around there in a minute. There you go. That's the safari zone. And we've got a blocked off bit here. Now, this does need work. This hasn't been worked on for a very specific reason. That's, I built two little research pods, basically just to research the animals as much as possible. And I've assigned people just to work there. I did the same with the mechanics, but it still didn't bloody work because the mechanics are awful. So when that's finished, we're going to redesign this whole area into something else. But that'll be towards the end. Oh, he's on the move. Doesn't look good through there. Anyways, onwards. People are going to comment. I know, I make everything into a forest. I'm obsessed with foliage. Get over it. I can't not do it. And we walk along, and we can see over here there's a sign saying down this way there's Chief Beef and Gulpy. But I think we're going to take a little break and head over to the mandrills for now. And there is our mandrill exhibit. Up there is a bed on that very top shelf, and they will actually climb up and use it. It's pretty cool. And this is really the best way to view the mandrills, isn't it? I don't know where they are right now, but there's definitely a couple of mandrills in there. Oh, there's one over there. Jumping. He's doing a leap. There they are. Yeah, the climbing is finicky, I think we've all realised. But, whoop, there he goes. He's a machine. Oh no, I didn't mean to do. Oh no, I've screwed this up. Oh, I'm just gonna hold that. I can't do much about that. The game's bugging out a little bit. So, anyways, you'd go see the mandrels in this lovely mooted area. I know the moat's not part of the exhibit, but it's for aesthetics, folks. It's for aesthetics. I'm not meant to be here. So, you'd carry on walking if you wanted. Ignore the mandrels. You get a nice glass wall view of the safari zone. We can see our zebra there. We can see. Oh no, baby zebra right there. Look, hello. Zebra there as well. Oh look, four zebras all hanging out, two babies. Got a big old giraffe, two big old three, four many giraffes, and some elephants down there in the distance. There's also some springboks running around. You can just about see one over there. If you, it's a hot day. You're in India. It's a warm place. You know, you need a drink. There's the baby. We're just gonna check out the baby. We'll come back and give the safari zone another look anyway. We're not done with the safari zone, but you need a drink for now. So you walk forward, you see a sign for the watering hole. You feel like watering your hole sounds like a good idea. And you walk forward, and there is my lovely little gulpy, chief beef, and information. I do want to get, like, other buildings, but, again, mechanic research sucks. So we've got six benches, some of them are shelters, some of them aren't. And this is path that you can walk on. You just make a grid using the path tool. There we go, there's the watering hole. Moving on, next exhibit before we wrap back around. Actually, no, let's go this way first. We'll wrap back around this way. So let's finish off the safari zone next. Moving on. You're floating, aren't you? Yes, fantastic. Lots of people over here. You can kind of see why. These are lots of very high-profile animals. We've got a lovely waterfall in the distance. We will walk in there and check it out properly. But we're going to go upstairs for now. And to our... This isn't quite finished, admittedly. But we'll walk in here for now. And, have a little look around. This is our safari zone viewing area. As I stand on the balcony, seems very safe. Our giraffes, our zebras. Where's my elephants at? There they are. Oh, he's going for a swim. Is he going for a swim? I think he's going for a swim. People are loving it. There's a child inside the wall. It's terrifying. I'm going in. Can I jump? I'm not going in. Okay, we're going to go in the other side. Let's go explore the safari zone a little bit before we move on. And then there's only two more exhibits left to go, folks. Although one of them is my piece de resistance. It's the Gemsbok. I've been working hard on the Gemsbok. Let's have a little look around. I did put some plants in. I know people think I make everything into a forest, but I've been moderately restrained. It's still very open and savanna-like. Right? Let's pack me up here. Let's have a little look. Got tons of giraffes. It really is. The zebras especially. I only had two zebras. And now there's this entire thriving population. And I keep getting rid of them. Same with the springbok. I only had two. Same with the giraffes. I had three giraffes. They just keep pumping out kids. It's great. The elephants are a little bit harder to breed, but they do it. There's a baby springbok. Hi, buddy. How you doing? Adorable. Giraffe having a snooze. Little baby zebra. Go check out over here. With my big damp elephant and a baby zebra. Maybe he's helping the zebra out. You know, the zebra's kind of stuck in the water. There's my, I might get rid of the rocks, actually. Yeah, I'm going to get rid of the rocks. There's my waterfall. Hard work. The waterfalls are hard work, I'm telling you. But it's pretty nice, I think. Oh, calm down, buddy. Tell you what, while there's a staff member here, I'm just going to... Oh, I don't need to. I'm just going to get rid of those. I don't like those. This is a good tour. You're a park guest who wants... Look at that. That's beautiful. I consider covering that whole thing in rocks, but I really like modelling, although that left bit needs a bit of work. I really like modelling with the chisel tool and the natural terrain. You'll see that again in a little bit, but I think it's really effective, so I'm going to stick with it as it is. And look at this whole area with like barely any plants. Be proud of me. I want to see the baby elephant. I want to see the baby elephant in the light. There he is. I think it's a he. I hope it's a he. The he's go for a little bit more money. Just gonna tramples that baby zebra, not a care in the world. Where are you off to, buddy? It's good though, isn't it? It looks nice, it's pretty. Pretty, pretty. We're gonna have to get you some food, buddy, aren't we? It's looking a bit bare bones, that. Okay. We can always come back and look at these in other future videos. So that is the safari zone pretty much done. Now, oh yeah, I forgot about these guys. So I know that's a wolf sign, but there's no wild dog sign. So over here we have the wild dogs. That's our little entrance. And we walk down here and we've just got a little very simple shrouded, whoop your head on the string, little shrouded viewing area, just some glass and... It's a very simple exhibit. We kept things a little bit more chill. I've added some uppy downy bits. I don't know what else to call it. Some undulation in the earth. There you go. In terra firma. Let's hop inside. We do have some babies, I think. Although the babies may have grown up since I was last here. It's got at least three. Where's the babies? And we're knocking on. Ah! Oh! Look at the baby! Oh, he's up. He's up in a boot. I feel very tall. Okay, so we've got like six wild dogs. Nicely reeded little viewing area there. Hop back inside, just pretend I'm a ghost. Little conservation bits there as well. Moving on! So, where's the warthog from here? Right, okay, so this is again another staff area. Block that off. Not allowed down there. That's where bad people go. We're not allowed to look to the left either. We're just going to look at the warthog exhibit, which is right here. I really like each exhibit to have like a gimmick of some description, and this was just the cave. If we actually follow this path, I'm just going to go off path a little bit. If we go down here, we approach from this side. This is by the hippo from earlier. You can see here, now we can't really do it, but this bit here is, yeah, there's one there. The warthogs sleep in that little area there. So the idea is you can stand here and look down and see them. It's not quite there because it's a little bit high and this is a little bit low, but generally speaking, you can look through this hollowed out cave sort of area and look down and see the sleeping warthogs. Not allowed down there though. No, no, no. Okay. Come back over here in a minute. Not allowed to look. I'm trying very much to hide that right hand side. Yeah, there's our little warthog exhibit. I thought that was a warthog then, it was a boulder. Have a little look in here. How are you guys doing? Oh, he's on the move. I wish I knew what to do about you, buddy. I really do. You're just full on broken. It's very sad. Right, so the final exhibit then. You guys saw in yesterday's video, we were working on a Gemsbok exhibit with geysers, and it looks pretty cool. I mentioned at the end that I wanted to do like a backdrop, you know, like a rocky terrain instead of a barrier at the back. And then I thought, well, I don't have to do viewing for it. So originally the plan was to have just a raised platform that looked out onto it. But I wanted to do something a little bit different. So let's go explore my newest exhibit, the newest addition to Burret Vichar Park, specifically the newest addition to the African Adventure Zone is Gemsbok and geysers. And there we go, we've got a little geyser pool right there, just as an introduction to what you're about to experience. So you walk forward, you learn all about the Gemsbok. And we've got two ways of viewing them. You can walk up this little hill here, and you can get a view into their exhibit like so, and they will sleep there, as you can see, with our adorable little baby sleeping right there in front of our viewing area. But if you want to go a little crazy, and you do, trust me, we're going to go, I really like this, by the way. It reminds me of like Universal Studios and stuff like that, where you'd have like a little themed area right around an exhibit. No. Oh, and a ride, whatever. Moving on. Before we go to the exit, we have this area down here. This is the continuation of Gemsbok and geysers. Warning, splash zone, and we've got these handy little signs in here because you're meant to walk down the left and exit down the right, and hopefully I think that gets that across pretty well. And as you can see, I made a tunnel. Sort of. It's a sort of tunnel. It's like a covered area up here. Very deserty and sort of dry. There's a little floating rock there, which is on purpose. I like floating rocks. And then you walk up. That skirt is far too small. What would your parents think? Seriously, also your legs are just legs for days. Moving on, we walk up the hill. There's some glass there for protection, but you look to the left, and that is Gemsbok and geysers. I've got these geyser pools everywhere. I've got this like mist in the water to give the impression that the water's like giving off loads of heat and steam. The geysers pop up all on different times as well, which is nice. Just wait for it. Ooh. In the distance, just see them pop up there. Some dust moves around everything. The Gemsbok and geysers. I was going for something. Are you escaping? I'm a little nervous they're going to escape. I've got to be honest. Because I kind of changed up the entire area. As you can see, I've kind of put this massive wall at the back and stuff like that. Gemsbok and geysers. I'm really happy with this. I think because I had this idea of this desolate, sandy desert landscape with geysers, which is the kind of environment you tend to find geyser pools and stuff like that, and I really wanted to recreate it, and you know what, I think I did. I try not to big myself up, I do a terrible job, but this one I am genuinely really proud of. I think it's really effective. And then you can walk down here, and then you go down, and then you walk back the way you came. It's nothing that exciting here, but you can look through the glass and hopefully see some Gemsbok wandering around. We'll just hop into the actual exhibit itself as well, temporarily. Yeah, this is what I mean by I like modelling with the Earth itself. You know, I just think it. I just think it looks great. And this is just making a big old hill with the pull tool, and then using the chisel tool to make it look more natural. Let's have a look inside. I love it. I really love it. I'm sorry. I think this is the best thing I've done. I don't think it's even close. What are you doing, buddy? And the Gemsbok are awesome. It's worth pointing out. The Gemsbok are just very, very cool. What are you doing, baby? Gonna find your papa, or your mama. I actually don't know the gender dimorphism. Some of them are brighter than the others. I assume one of those is a gender thing. And they're cute. I'll have a little look around. Someone's added me to their friend list. That's nice. Got a little pool over here. Did you have some enrichment? A toy? Pooh, geyser. there is like a water spout effect you can use. Oh! But I found it's not as effective as just the smoke. Got a little cave system here with some plants in. My one, I let myself have some plants. The idea being this little secret cave where the plants manage to grow in relative safety. Tell me that's not awesome. I'm sorry. I'm really happy with this. And the Gemsbok love it. I mean, they keep trying to move over here. I think they think they can maybe escape, but I'm going to maybe kill that little bit there. But it's all covered in dirt and... Okay, it seems I can get out, but they can't seem to get out, so... I spoke too soon! I've made a terrible mistake. Guys, do you want to... I'll fix that. I can fix that, that's fine. Gonna come back down? I'm gonna have to fix that. I thought they'd be able to escape somewhere. I've not really tested the exhibit since I did all this design work. I'll fix that in a minute. It's fine. It's fine. It's low priority. But yeah, Gemsbok and Geysers, folks. There it is. The last African exhibit for now. I'm going to show you the exit, and then we will talk about what I mean by last African exhibit by now. Because I know we don't have lemurs, I know we don't have lions, we don't have Nile monitors. There's a few African animals we don't have quite yet. So, you walk down here, there's our sign pointing out Sorry Zone, Gemsbok, Warthog, Tortoise, South Sable, Antelope, Ostrich, and Buffalo. And also an exit sign there, and then you walk over here, see a hippo booty, exit, and it's just a little African adventure sign there with the hippo to let you into the African adventure. Obviously, that's meant to be the main entrance over there. This is more like a little side entrance, but after this, we're gonna, you know, walk off into the rest of the park and do the rest of the zoo, basically. So, a handset. I have to hold the middle mouse button for the entire thing. Are you the dead warthog? Which is the dead warthog? So this is my plan going forward. I'm gonna talk about this very briefly. I had an idea of, so obviously the beta ends in like 8 days, and Planet Zoo is doing really, really well. I love having it on the channel, I love uploading it, I love doing these enclosures for you guys. You know, all of them, I've really enjoyed it, and several of them I haven't included in videos, like the warthog, for example, we didn't do in a video, or the wild dogs we didn't do in a video. My theory going forward is to make a video out of every single exhibit, and then pre-record ahead of time, essentially. So the zoo's going to take longer to complete in terms of how you guys see it, but you'll get to see every single exhibit, and we'll then have content for the weeks after the beta ends. So I'm going to try to pre-record at least like a week or so ahead of time, so for a week after the beta, we'll still be able to see the zoo getting built. I think that'd be really cool. So I've kind of laid out a plan for the entire zoo, where every single animal is going to go, and I have certain sections. The Nile, for example, the Nile monitor is going to go in the reptile house that we're building next, or the rainforest house, I'm calling it, that we're building next. But if there's time, and if I can pre-record ahead of time enough, we can also come back and build like a more African-themed Nile monitor one. It's the same for the lemur and the lion. I want to do like a big cat sanctuary area, specifically for the three big cats, if you include a snow leopard. So the lion is going to go there, but if we get enough time at the end, we'll come back and have left room for the lion, the lemur, and the Nile monitor. We can always push this back if we need more room and do things here, make a bit more space. The point is, I've got room for expansion if need be, and if not, it doesn't really look... I mean, I can colour that in and make that a bit ragged, and it'll look fine, it'll blend in with Africa perfectly well. But my hope is that we can pre-record all these videos and all these animals ahead of time, and then move on. So, that's why no lion, that's why no lemur, that's why no Nile. They're all set for other exhibits, basically. Same with the hippo. We could bring a hippo into Africa, potentially, because we have a hippo at the start, but we don't have an African-themed hippo. So that's my idea. And that's why. And that's about it. Thank you so much for all the comments. Thank you for all the support. You guys have been so nice about my zoo. It makes me feel really good. Like, it's sad, but it's where I get all my approval in my life from at this point in time. So keep it up. Thank you very much. And next episode, rainforest building thing. Very cool. Thanks for joining me. If you enjoyed this video and if you've enjoyed our African adventure, which is over for now, but only for now, then please do hit the like button. Remember to subscribe for more Planet Zoo videos, including not just exhibit builds. We're going to be doing some other stuff as well, like we did earlier today. So see you next time. Cheers much love as always. Bye bye. Hey folks, thanks for watching. If you enjoyed this video and you want to help support me a little bit more, you can do so at patreon.com/bestinslot. There's a link in the description down below. Every little really does help in times like these, but it's not at all expected, and by just watching the video you've already helped me out massively, and it makes you a pretty cool person, so well done you. Thanks for joining me either way, I'll see you next time.